Welcome everybody, welcome back to the channel, and we had to put the Baron's mission on hold because we literally did not know what to do. We don't have any leads on his wife, Anna, so now we're finding the Crones of Crookback Bog. And who? Hello? Why are you running up on me like that? One second.
Not bad.
All right, to back to where we was. So we're trying to find the Crones of Crookback Bog. Those donuts? Ew.
I'm on the right path.
Is this like, What's that? What's that little thing? I forgot what it's called, but it was where they was, it was about the, I guess the two little kids and they, or was it just one kid? They left a trail to like they left pieces of candy to the witch's house, and then the witch ate them or something like that. Something stupid like that. This is how I'm feeling like this is. Because they got these little donut things. Just one second before we Before we get in, I gotta see what fairy tale that was. Which I don't have the right context to be.
Dug him in the kitchen. Stole a hunk of meat. Cook gave him a licking. Strung him by his feet.
Cook then bled him empty. Stripped his skin off clean.
Laughed and said how tasty. Best sausage I have seen.
Cook's a stupid killer. Shouldn't have ate the pup.
Now we'll light a fire. Gonna roast him up.
1, 2, 3. The one to fetch the kindlings. Thee!
Interesting rhyme.
Don't know you. Go away.
I'm looking for the witches of Crookback Bog.
You look like a witch yourself. The witches of the bog. We can't go in the bog. Gran don't let us.
When my brother Zemek went missing, Gran said it was because he went in the woods and got lost. Gran cried an awful lot after that.
You could still come back.
What are you doing out here alone?
We's not alone.
We's with Gran.
But where did you all come from?
We's orphans.
All of you?
There's a war, so there's orphans. Didn't know that.
A young woman got lost in the swamp. She has ashen hair and a scar on her face. You kids see anyone like that?
Ain't no lassies here.
What am I?
You're no lassie. Lassies got tits.
They do. Heard an old man say once, when the army was here, he says, "I them lasses in the woods. They's dazzling the soldiers with their tits. And it's torturing the poor lads." That's what he said.
Yes, is this girl in trouble?
Listen, the girl I'm looking for, she's in trouble. I understand you might not want to help me, but you could try to help her.
How do you know she was here?
I heard she visited the witches in the swamp.
But there's no witches here.
There's only frogs.
And snakes.
And Johnny.
What's this talk? What kind of jabbering is this, eh? No one allowed here. Just kids. My kids, they're allowed. But who are you, wearing swords like a bandit?
Who's Johnny?
Johnny ate a cat. Come the more in some furry shat.
Watch your language. They tells tales and tales, naught but tales.
Are you one of the witches of the swamp? I hear Crookback Bog.
Witch? Me? Nay, I've no broom nor owl and not one wart on me nose. Got a pretty nose, see?
Gwen's got a lovely beak.
Oh, you darling girl. Our kids are so sweet.
Seems like you look like one of them witches.
You look after these kids?
They're my grandchildren.
Gran's good to us. Gonna be soup with scratchings for supper.
Kids get lost in the woods. I miss them. Seen them in the woods? No one has.
Just talking to the kids. Asked them if they'd seen a young woman.
I was a lovely young woman. Wore a long, beautiful braid my mummy did up for me. Had dresses with flowers on them.
Maybe you've seen her. Young, ashen hair.
Your betrothed?
Daughter, actually.
Daughter? My dear, sweet little daughter and her sister. Where are they now? Maybe they've come to some harm?
A bit of help, please. A young, ashen-haired woman. Just need to know if you've seen her.
What are you looking at, children? Wash your hands, we'll go catch crickets.
Won't learn anything from you.
Aye. Because I don't know nothing.
That Johnny knows. He knows a lot. When I ask him something, he says, "Wait, I'll scratch my arse and tell you."
Ugly word. What you saying? To the hut. You'll stand in a corner. I'll make sure you do. You. Be gone. Be gone!
That lady ain't right.
Can't come in here. Not allowed in here.
I just want to talk to the boy.
Not allowed. It's not allowed.
He won't talk to you anyway. Gran don't like you. And Johnny's made up. And strangers steal kids.
Just got one question for you.
Don't be asking no questions. You're a stranger. Not allowed to talk to strangers.
Can we eat now? Soup with scratchings.
You hear? Says he's afeard of you. Stop scaring my kids.
Why don't you want to talk about Johnny? one of you knows about him. The others must too.
It's just him who's pals with Johnny. They pick mushrooms and hunt snails. But Gran says Johnny's made up.
Yeah, have you ever seen John? Johnny?
Of course. Like, looks just like him.
Then why do you say he's made up?
Gran says so. And Gran knows lots.
Does your Gran treat you right? She ever hurt you?
Never.
When we're bad, she cries.
She's scared. Says strangers might take us. And we'll disappear.
I'm not thinking... Hold on. This old lady. She's not too... She ain't well in the head.
The boy who plays with Johnny. He must be brave.
Not brave. Just stupid.
Sat his bare bum on an anthill once. But yeah, he plays with Johnny. He don't listen to Gran and goes in the woods, and then he's got to have a time out.
And he eats snails. Yuck.
The girl I mentioned is in danger. You gotta help me get your Gran away from the hut so I can talk to Johnny's friend.
All right, but you gotta do something for us too. Play hide and seek. Gran never does. Says her feet hurt.
Let's do it.
Let's play. You hide, but if I find you, you have to help me talk to the boy who knows Johnny.
He thinks he'll find us easy.
Means he's never hid from the black ones.
No looking, and you have to count out loud. All your fingers, toes, two.
One, two,
I can't believe they got him doing this.
18, 19, 20. Ready or not, here I come.
Oh no, I'm a witcher.
Found you. You can stop hiding.
I mean, he wasn't hiding in a spot that. Yeah, he wasn't hiding in a spot that I couldn't. Not see you.
I can see you.
I mean, that was a good spot. I can't front him on that one. You're in those bushes right
there
here.
You are.
If you wasn't just bobbing and weaving, I would have never saw you. Okay, I just need one more. Thank you. There you are.
No one left hiding.
You're a wizard, right? Gonna show us some tricks when we get to the cottage.
No, we'll talk about your promise. Found you all. Now you gotta keep your word and help me talk to Johnny's friend.
Why wouldn't we? Promised, didn't we?
Gran! Gran! Bumblebee bit Yagner in the arse! Gran! Come!
Don't be afraid.
Don't know nothing.
I won't hurt you.
Where's Gran?
She's busy. Why are you scared to talk?
I'm not scared of nothing.
You're all scared of something. Would have told me about Johnny otherwise.
I'm worried about Johnny. He don't come around no more. Once, when we was mushroom picking, he saw his burrow, but Gran yelled at me, said not to talk to strangers, cause then kids go missing. She worries about Johnny too, though she says he's made up.
Where are you and your friends?
That's what I would like to know.
Dad, some starved, others were killed, like mine. One day, I went out at dawn to look for berries in the woods. Still some around back then. When I was coming home, I heard the yells, then laughing. Went up and hid in the bushes near the woods. My mum yelled, and the soldiers laughed.
Oh.
Laid my paw down by the barn door. His head clean off. And then my mom.
It's all right. That's enough.
They lived through some trauma.
I just want to talk to Johnny. He could know more than you.
Not gonna hurt him, right? Because he's real. He's not made up.
I'm not gonna hurt him.
Johnny used to be boy, because Gran liked listening to his songs. When we was picking mushrooms, Johnny said he saw a girl with ashen hair in the swamp.
Where can I find Johnny?
There's a little meadow on the edge of the swamp. This strange tree grows there. Look around. You'll see him.
Thank you.
It's not that ain't good. You got drowners and hags.
Johnny's real. He must leave prints.
There's some footprints.
Small footprint. Johnny's been through here.
This way.
Show me what you got.
It said Crones or Crookback bog. Right? So there should be more than one. But we only seen one, only see one lady.
Tracks lead to a burrow. Wonder what's inside.
Johnny? Don't be afraid.
Johnny, a human.
You're a bucka? A lutin? Ah, a godling. Not many of you left. I'm looking for a woman with ashen hair. Seen her? Tell me everything from the start. Where did you see her? What was she doing? It's important to me. Why not? You know the kids from the clearing well? Don't be afraid. Not gonna hurt anyone. This where you live? Cozy burrow. Good location. Must know about everything that happens in the bog. Doesn't bother you having monsters for neighbors?
What? I don't think he can talk.
What's wrong? Can't talk? Why? Lost your voice? Can I help you somehow? Want me to follow you?
That was clear as day. Why would I even say that?
No choice, I guess.
Oh, Johnny's on the run.
Watch out!
Well, how long are you gonna make me wait? Stay close to me.
Where did Johnny go?
This the place? Let me look around. Something's on the ledge? Something that'll get you your voice back? Guess I gotta make this climb.
I could have went around, you know, stretched my legs out a little bit.
Show me what you got.
These harpies? Oh, they are little harpies. I thought they were just birds. Why did that just float in the air?
Maybe he meant this bottle.
Bumblebee! Flabbergasted! Ha! The sound of it!
Peter Piper picked Prince Proxima a pack of pickled peppers by the Pontar.
Done celebrating?
My favorite words! Life without savoring the sound of surreptitious shenanigans is like licking snails through a cloth. Thank you for this, noble whoever you are. Long be your life!
Hang on a minute. I helped you, now you help me.
Would you turn this beautiful act of altruism into a banal bartering of favors?
Yeah, why'd you lose your voice?
How'd you lose your voice?
One morning I awoke and opened my mouth for my usual bout of singing with the thrushes. Lo and behold, no sound escaped. I tried and tried, almost burst a blood vessel. Then I went to the village, because word has it, the new cunning woman works miracles. But people began crying out, "A smudger! A smudger!" and sick their dogs on me. Do I look like a smudger to you?
Not a bit.
Well, I thought not. So it must be the Crones doing. Who else would curse me? Blackbird friend of mine located my voice, but I was helpless to retrieve it.
Couldn't ask a raven friend to just give you the bottle?
Ravens serve the Crones. They don't help no one.
How do you lock someone's voice in a bottle? Just wondering.
As am I, especially as mine's a voice to crown all voices. Sometimes it's like a forest brook, at others like a roll of thunder. And let's be honest, I talk enough to fill 3 barrels or more.
Somebody used some powerful magic on you, as a prank or just to be mean. I'm looking for a young, ashen-haired woman. See anyone like that?
Did I ever? Remember it as if it were yesterday. Soon as I woke, I went to empty my bowels. My favorite part of the day. Defecating to the sunrise, downright glorious. Suddenly, heard a bang, so loud it couldn't have been me. And that lass appeared, out of nowhere. Young, ashen-haired, just like you said. Wounded and panting to boot. She raced off towards the children's huts. Quick as if the Crones were after her. I yelled some unpleasantries. She disturbed my morn. Sadly, I'd lost my voice, so I don't think she heard me.
Yeah, do you know anything about these Crones?
What do you know about the Crones?
They're as old as this forest. Cruel, vindictive, not to be crossed.
What if someone does cross them?
Might take his voice, might take his life. Depends on their whim. They're nasty. Although, they care for this land and its folk in their own way. Supposedly, they always keep their word, but you must be careful what you ask for. Won't find them until they want to be found. See them until they want to be seen. But remember, they see and hear all that happens in the mire.
I've been to the village in the swamp, met a woman who might have been a crone.
Did she seem confused to you?
Nuts, completely.
So I'm not crazy. That's no crone. That's the granny who takes care of the orphans. Claims the kids made me up. Me.
An orphanage in a swamp?
What do you have against swamps? Lived here my whole life, and I heartily recommend it.
She ran off toward the orphanage. Kids could know something. Or the old woman who takes care of them.
Oh, that old hag don't speak to strangers. And you're a stranger.
Will she talk to you?
I have spoken to her, got my ways. So be it. You helped me and I'm no bore. come with me.
Okay, I don't know how you... Well, I guess.
Damn it.
Not bad.
I'll beat this hag. She's annoying, bro. I need to repair my swords and my chest piece, or at least get another chest piece. I'm following you to the village. I need you to walk faster. There she is.
Good. It's clear. Not a crone in sight. I need to sing to Gran. That ought to calm her.
Little Johnny softly gazing, fire waning pale. Pop! A spark jumped out and whispered, "Listen, I'm a tale."
You got your voice back.
I did, though I seem to have lost an octave somewhere in the process. I shall look for it when I get home.
You're not allowed here, Johnny. You shouldn't have come.
Calm down, Gran. Don't get angry. It's not good for you.
Yeah, let me to these Crones.
Can you take me to the Crones?
Forgive me, Gran. But this fellow absolutely must talk to the ladies.
No. She's not allowed.
Please, it's important.
The fellow will be quiet. Gran, please hear me out. I found little Yagna when she got lost, did I not? Did I break Ginny's fever too? I did. I ask anything in return? No. Didn't even fuss about my stolen voice. Well, now I want something. Gran, help this fellow. Because otherwise he'll pester me day and night, even during potty time. His lass is missing. Perhaps the ladies can help find her, eh?
Well, since you put it that way, Johnny, I'll help him. Come with me.
It seems like that boy knows a lot about the Crones. Oh, you mean they was in that house the whole time?
Johnny's a good lad, though the ladies don't like him. No, foul creature, they say, don't like him.
Who are the women in the tapestry?
Those are the ladies. Ladies lovely, with power over all. Answer my call. Before you a worm crawls, wretched and small.
How dare you disturb our rest, woman?
someone speaking through you?
Good looking and clever, too. Where have you been hiding, boy?
Yeah, that's not how I imagine you looking. Or do I wanted? I wanted to talk to you. I'm gonna be
looking
nice.
For the woman with ashen hair. I know you met her. Where is she?
Oh, he's impatient. Perhaps he only likes ashen-haired girls.
The young woman. She's my daughter by choice. I raised her.
If she's shapely, what does it matter?
Matters to me.
I believe we've hit a nerve. He's bubbling like well-fed yeast. Oh, that's how I like him.
It's clear you met her. Tell me everything.
That was blunt. Well, perhaps it's for the best. Tell me, have you got bollocks? Do you fear woodland beasts? Oh, hard times are upon this white-haired one. Brother has turned against brother. The land is soaked in blood. Evil reigns stronger than ever before.
A dark power has surfaced near Dunwarren. It feeds on hatred and disdain. Destroy the beast, and we will be grateful. Tell you all we know about this ashen-haired maid.
Dark power? You need a knight errant, or a witch hunter, not a witcher.
The alderman of Dunwarren will tell you all. Remember to collect payment from him after you complete your task. And now our servant will bring you the dagger.
Yeah, why you need
a dagger? What for?
When the alderman sees this dagger, he'll know we sent you. He'll aid with all.
I'll talk to the alderman, but I can't promise anything.
Move, woman! Give the young man the dagger.
And you, White One, return only once you've completed the task.
Aye, mistress, right. On me way. Dagger. Gotta bring the dagger. The dagger. For you. Lady told me to give it you. Here it is. The dagger.
I wonder if she's crazy.
Place the alderman's payment on the stone. Stone bear. Stone shear. Stone nose, stone ears.
Alrighty. I'm not fighting y'all, bro. I'm gonna walk right past you. That's rude. You're gonna stop throwing these bow and arrows at me. I'll tell you that right now.
Don't let him catch his breath!
I mean crossbow, I'll say bow and arrow. You're gonna stop shooting me with your crossbow.
Greetings. Nice village.
Aye.
A real pearl of the swamps.
If you say so.
You get by all right?
Aye, winter to winter. Somehow we survive.
Recognize this dagger?
Aye, master. I didn't know you belonged to them.
Don't belong to anyone. Down to business. I want to get this done quickly.
Ah, so that's how it's to be.
I'm supposed to help solve your problem. Tell me what it is. Just the essentials.
The war awoke an ancient power. An evil one that feeds on bloodshed. Nightmares haunt our nights and days. Folks sleepwalk from their homes, never to return. Under the tree on the Whispering Hillock they lie. Unburied all. Fathers, sons, daughters, and mothers. Folk are afeard to move them. You must go there. The dark powers must be cast off.
Yeah, I need some more details, bro.
Need more details.
You must see for yourself. Me grand's mum whacked me crosswise for straying near the Whispering Hillock. But what happens there now is a wonder.
A few times folk from round here gathered to chop down the trees and burn the cursed soil back to use. None returned. The ground beneath the weeds is white with human bones.
When did all this start?
3 year back. I remember, 'twas a warm day. Went to check the snares for game. Pulled a hare from me trap. It grew dark all of a sudden, though it was nigh on noontime. Thought it was a storm at first. A squeal pierced the air, near burst me ears. The hair rotted in me hands, and the leaves shriveled and yellowed, though it were yet the start of summer. Times have been ill ever since. Folks' teeth turn black as charcoal. Women folk fight like polecats, bawling and brawling over nothing. The young'uns, born crippled, lame. Fear and cursing. Long have we pled for the lady's help.
Ladies of the Wood don't know what this power is?
They know all. Old Thecla claimed they'd be punishing us. Folks stop respecting them. Some even call them witches. But must not be they, for they sent you.
I'll look around the Whispering Hillock.
You be careful, Master Witcher. Don't ye treat this evil light.
Alright, let's repair my my armor. And my sword. Since I'm dealing with monsters, I'll just do the silver sword. Silver sword. Sword, please. Roach. Where are you at? I guess this is where we go on foot. You stay there, Roach.
Be gone. Come no closer. I know whence you come.
A voice from within the tree.
The powers that protect me, they sense whence you come.
So where are you? Where are you at then? Well, it has to be a cave somewhere. Heartbeat or something. There it is. Werewolf?
Be gone! Be gone! Be gone! The powers will not relent.
Magic. A place of power.
Why'd he turn red like that? Yeah, we dodged him. I wonder if he's gaining health while I'm hitting him. I think he is. Yeah, he is gaining health.
Who are you?
I haven't found one of these.
Be gone. Be gone. Be gone.
Something tells me I gotta use Igni. Because I did. I just got a power boost from it, so Igni must be used.
Why have you come? Why spill this blood? Are you here to grant me death? Or is my freedom your wish?
Was attacked.
This is my prison, a fortress. witnesses I await, and my forest protects me.
Murderers?
Murder sisters. Killed my body. Now my soul may hunt, for I defy them.
Who are you?
I abandoned my circle, where I kept the balance. The Crones killed me, and cursed my ghost.
Never heard of a druid circling Velen.
I wander eternally through a maze of boughs, helplessly sliding over rust.
Must know the Crones pretty well.
They are Velen's curse. They hear all through severed ears. They weave hair and twist lives. They take their strength from a broth of human flesh.
Why did they kill you?
The Crones want this land. They'd rule the wood alone. I stood in their way. I had to die.
You claim to be imprisoned. How so?
I am bound here, in fetters of magic. I wandered endlessly, along the thieves, the children. I know all. I know what awaits them. Free me, please. I must help.
If something threatens the orphans, I'll help them myself.
The children have been taken. Free me, please. I come be a gale, a gallop unchained. I shall save them. Only I can.
Hold on.
Why do you think the kids from the meadow are in danger?
The sisters took them. They shall not return.
Where'd they take them? I can help.
It is done already. It cannot be undone. There are no runes to art ceremony. They shall all die. Let them be saved.
The Crones. What do you know about them?
The sisters are older than the oldest trees. Velen is their realm. All life here serves them. The sisters live concealed. You will not find them. They hear all. You cannot hide.
So, I don't know if to help. It looks like he knows a lot. Oh, man. I'm gonna do this.
If you can save the orphans from the meadow, I'll help you.
I will find them. Free them. Open the door of my cage.
I thought you said you knew where they were.
Blood is my escape. A rite you must perform. With the black of raven feathers, the white of my bones, and a swift steed. A mare wild and free. In meadows past. Dark as a bottomless well, black as the depths of night. Such a beast, no other. Gather these and bring them here.
Got some raven feathers.
Find my remains and bring me a mount.
A wind-born steed, a black
wall
turned horse.
Alright, his voice has changed.
Why do we need a black horse?
The beast and I shall be as one. As when I lived, we shall be a gale. Nothing to stop us. A wild steed from meadows moist.
Where'll I find your remains?
My bones? They lie.
gather what I need to free you, then return.
Gather and return to the Ilamic's depths, to the tree's rotten heart. Pierce my heart. Let blood flow to be born again. I must first be consumed.
Go now and return through the passage I have opened.
Place of power. Should draw from it.
You already draw from it. So I really gotta do what he's... I gotta see what this quest. I got the feathers. Need a black horse. Let me look at this quest. Is it a secondary? Okay. Find the bones of the spirit trapped beneath the whispered hillock. Using the Witcher sense. I gotta find these bones. Found the bones of the spirit trapped beneath the whispering hillock using. This is
strange bones. Don't seem human to me.
Climbing the wild horse using. I might have to betray this man. Or whoever he is. even girl says, like, strange bones. Black horse just in the wild. Okay.
Take it easy. Go, go.
Ready. We can start.
And break the steed.
I offer raven feathers.
Once I was free, I shall be free once more.
I offer your remains.
Once I was flesh, I shall be flesh once more.
No, I should draw your blood now. Let the horse drink it. But I won't. I don't trust you. I have to stop you, destroy you.
Betrayed.
Do as a horse.
Medallion's humming. Place of power, it's gotta be. Solved your problem. Just in case, though, avoid the Whispering Hillock for a while.
Cannot be. Where's something lurking there?
Should I just tell him? Like... Or should... we don't know what it was, like... I'm just saying spirit.
An evil spirit had possessed a tree on the hill. It was responsible for the killings.
How'd ye dispel this evil?
Some being had come to possess the tree's heart. I destroyed the heart and its inhabitant.
So it were a ghost. Will it be back?
No. The Crones, or the Ladies of the Wood as you call them, said to remind you about payment. Take it you know what they want?
Aye, I do. Give me the dagger. Be back soon. There's payment. Take it to the ladies, will you?
What the hell was that?
Tis our pact. You're a stranger. You don't know life here. It's honest pay for their protection.
So, all those ears in the woods.
Put it out your mind, Master. You soon be leaving, and we must tarry on our young'uns and their young'uns after him. No gods nor masters watch over Velen. The land is no man's. He who wants to survive must seek his own protectors.
Okay. Should have.
Sheathe your weapon, young man.
He's even lovelier in real life. Mm.
In real life, you're different than you were in the tapestry.
Well, bring it here.
You can bring it, not ogle it.
What was that? That's Anna.
Never seek to cross us again.
We shall forgive you this transgression, for you've done well. Your children are plump as piglets, sweet as caramel.
But now we must talk to our white-haired friend.
I know that, Mark. This is Anna, the wife of the Baron of Crow's Perch.
She belongs to no man.
A fruit ripened in her womb. A fruit sprouted from seeds sown by a man she detested.
We helped her. She agreed to serve. She bears the mark. She is ours. Come. It is another woman who interests you. Speak, white-haired one.
You used me to tame the Whispering Hillock. A lot of work.
Lord's free, brave soul.
Did you destroy the evil powers? Have you brought peace to our domain?
Yes.
So fortunate to have found so brave a knight, so able.
What did you need the children for?
We? They needed us. Our care.
Where are they?
They are far away.
Their troubles are over.
No!
You looked different in the tapestry.
We're all dressed up just for you.
If you only knew how much time we spent in front of the glass.
Do you desire us?
I'm impressed. Polymorphism, a rare talent.
Oh, I'd suck every last drop out of you.
You see his face?
To be woven together with you? I'd be your best and last.
Not what I came for. Our deal. I did my part, now you do yours.
A word once given, we never break. The girl. Mousy blonde. That's what they call it.
terrified, exhausted. She could barely stand the poor thing.
We cared for her as best we could.
Like she was our own daughter.
Wasted affection. She proved a very naughty girl.
Mischievous, stubborn, and selfish.
The young woman I seek never hurt anyone without cause.
You've not seen her long. She's changed for the worse.
Why'd she attack you?
She's no longer the girl you once knew. Wrath consumes her.
Don't believe you. They say you always keep your word, so tell me everything, exactly as it happened.
We shall tell you, brave boy.
Oh, we got a flashback.
We knew someone special was to arrive. We read beast entrails, saw the omens.
We would glimpse her likeness, a mirage in a puddle. She came from the lower swamp.
We knew not at first it was her the omens had spoken of.
A child of the elder blood, the soul seed that would burst into flame.
She fell into our hands. Elder blood!
The blood of the traitress. Does she sleep?
Like a lamb.
Come, sisters, no point in dawdling. The table's set. The cauldron bubbles.
We cannot. You know she is meant for him.
Imlareth will get her. He will. But not whole.
Well said. We'll just have a sample.
I'll take her feet. Lovely. Plump. Perfect for a broth.
Oh, I can taste it already. Very well. Get on with it.
Oh, you'll regret that, girl. Regret it dearly.
To run. I thought I was over fighting. I was like, man, they can't hurt me.
Thank you.
tried to kill her. Tried to butcher her like an animal and eat her.
Her blood. The taste brought back memories of our youth.
Elder blood. Extraordinary girl. But you know that. Such a shame she fled.
So I was supposed to do this first and then do the Bladed Baron.
You tried to kill her. Can't forgive you for that.
Yeah, y'all gotta die.
Waste of words. Our fates are bound true. But now is not the time for that to bear fruit.
Now you shall chase shadows and wander midst fog.
Each time you see her, she will be a mirage. And if you find her, if the girl will die, she seeing you, handsome knight.
Okay, I might go back and help out the tree this time, but I'll do that on another playthrough. But I'll see y'all in the next Witcher video, and make sure you subscribe to the channel and smash that like button. Man, I messed up. Okay, we're back at the Baron's house and we're about to tell him about Anna.
Oh. I'm listening. What do you come to me with?
Got news of your wife.
Why'd you not say so forthwith? Where is she? Why have you not returned with her?
She's in Crookback Bog. Got food, a place to live, and keeps herself busy. Didn't look like she had the slightest desire to leave.
You were to bring her back, not report on the condition she lives under.
I was supposed to find her, and I did. That was our deal, nothing more.
He has a point.
You still think me rotten to the core? A base bastard, don't you? You believe I alone am at fault for what happened here.
My opinion doesn't matter?
Doesn't matter what I believe.
Yeah. Looking at you, I see contempt. Can't speak for the world you witches inhabit, but in ours, nothing is ever black and white.
Probably gonna say you're not the only one to blame. All right then, I'm willing to hear your side of the story.
Let's have a chat.
With Annie, it was love at first sight. A spear tore through my shoulder at the Battle of Anchor. She tended to my wound. Once I'd recovered, I asked her to marry me. She wept with joy. Soon after, Tamara was born. And after that, they sent me to Sidaris. A warlord had risen against King Ethan, and Foltest sent help. It was one battle to the next, one conflict after another. It was a life of war. I was seldom home, and I found comfort in drink. Grew so fond of hooch, I couldn't part with it when I did get home.
Still seems like your fault to me.
Will you let me finish?
All right. What then?
I went from front to front, battle to battle, collecting soldiers' coin, while Anna sat alone with the babe for months. Later, I learned she'd not been so alone after all. For nearly 3 years, she'd found comfort in the arms of one Evan, a childhood friend. A dog's bunghole. Understand, damn it. One tussle in the hay I'd have waved aside, put it out of my mind. But the woman cuckolded me for years, without a whisker of concern for me, for my love.
How'd you find out?
Came home one day and Anna was gone. The things too. Found a letter. She wrote that she didn't love me. That she'd left me for that knob licker and taken Tamara with her. Felt like I'd been rammed in the arse by a horse. I went to find the bugger to get the girls.
Oh, this is not fun.
Bring them home. Yet soon as I saw him, something turned inside me. Something dark. I slaughtered the shit-eating twat and fed his carcass to the dogs.
Guess they call you the Bloody Baron for a reason after all.
What?
Your nickname makes sense now.
No, no, that's an entirely different story.
Imagine Anna wasn't exactly pleased.
Ha! Bloody understatement if I've ever heard one. She flew into a fit, hysteria, threw herself at me, kicking and clawing. Finally grabbed a knife. It would have been the end of me if I'd not leapt aside. It was the first time I hit her. I had to calm her. Felt I had no other means. Things changed. They would never be the same. Anna tried to take her own life and mine several times. She would prod me, goad me, taunt me, in the hope I would hit her again, perhaps. She'd scream that I'd robbed her a life of love, that I'd destroyed the idea for her, and so might as well kill her. How many times I apologized. How many armfuls of blooms and gifts I brought. She cared not a bit. 2 years of her anger had turned to indifference. Broken at times were her bouts of hysteria and my bouts of drunkenness. Cannot fathom how we survived those years. But we did. And as you know now, not everything was as it might have seemed.
You're right. Faults on both sides, yours and hers.
I'm content that you finally see that. Very well then. If you won't bring Anna home, you might at least tell me how she landed in that blasted swamp.
Your wife is with the Crones as their servant.
What the fuck do you mean? What Crones?
Ones who live in Crookback Bog.
Heard folk speak of them, and thought it naught but tales to scare the children with. How on earth did she land there?
They fled by night. They were riding past the forest when a beast serving the Crones attacked them and abducted Anna.
A beast? Bloody hell. And Tamara? Was she hurt?
No.
Oh, thank the gods for that. So, Annie, what happened to her?
The creature carried her deep into Crookback Bog. Didn't harm her, though. In fact, Anna seems content there.
Content? What is this tribe, Witcher? What in bloody blazes is she doing in that swamp?
She made a pact with the Crones and, well, I think she might have lost her mind.
A pact? What the bloody hell?
She was with child, a child she didn't want to bear. Went to the Crones for help. They promised to rid her of the problem in exchange for a year of her service. And they kept their word in their own twisted way.
What do you mean?
Anna must have thought the child inside her would somehow disappear. Instead, the Crones sapped her of strength and ultimately forced her body to miscarry. I think that's when she started to lose her mind. Then they placed magic tethers on her, tethers that cause great pain when tested. A guarantee she'll pay off her debt.
A pact with witches? Bloody nightmare, sounds like some jest. We must get her out. We can't leave her there.
So it's all adding up together now. Like, now I can see the...
Venturing into the swamp, even with armed men, is just a bad idea. It's a dangerous place inherently. And I think those Crones are a greater threat than anyone realizes.
I'll not sit on my ass waiting for them to return her. Would you wait? Count on their mercy if they had your daughter?
Probably not. But I'm a witcher.
And I'm a husband and a father who's fought off his life and the lives of his loved ones. I'll gather my men. Go there and retrieve Anna.
Oh, let's play a game of Gwent first. No. Get that out of here.
We had a deal. I've done my part. Your turn to do yours.
A word once given. Now, what did I last?
Basilisk. It had just attacked you.
Ah, right. Gargantuan. One solid brute.